Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Kim with WorkHardTravelWell.com, and I'm coming to you today with a new video of the review of the Samsung UR55 4K Ultra High Definition Monitor. The Samsung UR55 28-inch ultra high definition monitor. It's 4K, which is right behind me. So you've probably seen my original video, which I did last month, which is an unboxing. If you haven't, you can check it out here. And I wanted to wait to do a review because I wanted to make sure I was gonna keep it. And also I just wanted to get some good use before I put up a review. So here's what I think about the Samsung monitor. If you're new to my channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I post new videos every week and I talk about travel tips and how you can travel more while working a full-time job. I also talk about behind the scenes, which is why I'm doing this video, about technology and also lifestyles. I will preface this by saying I originally sought out a new monitor because, like a lot of us, we're working from home more. When I started my search, it was for a true picture by picture monitor, not picture in picture, and being able to view two different sources on the screen at the same time, because I have two laptops, one for work and one for personal, and I don't like to put my personal information on my work computer. So when I researched, I saw that LG, Asus, and Samsung were some of the ones that came up for picture by picture. And I purchased an LG ultra wide monitor. It was a 21 inch from B&H Photo. And the description said it was picture by picture. When I received it, it was not picture by picture. It was picture in picture. And you could only view one source at a time. So I sent that back. Anyway, I just did some more research on picture by picture. I cross-referenced the manuals of Samsung and looked at some of the write-ups online, and this monitor has true picture by picture. So I'll show you a little bit about the specs as well as my thoughts. I'm not returning it. I will tell you that what I do for it is not gaming and things like that, so use case is different, but from a standpoint, I need a monitor that I can, like I said, be able to view work computer and personal computer at the same time. That was a functionality, as well as I edit videos, travel videos, I edit drone videos for this channel, and also I edit some of my travel photos, as well as I do graphic design for my online t-shirt apparel store, which is all on my website, workhardtravelwell.com. So that's why I purchased this computer. And a bonus, if you stay tuned, I'll tell you about how I'm able to use the same keyboard and same mouse on this setup. Okay, so like I said, I've already set up the monitor and you can view it in the unboxing and setup that I've already done. And it's basically connected to two laptops. One is an HP, the other is a Lenovo. Right now I only have it on one screen. The inputs on the back are a display port, one display port, headphone jack, two HDMI, and the power outlet. A lot of people are saying they're having a hard time tilting, you know, I would think you'd be able to tilt it from here, but to tilt it, you start at the top. So right now it's already tilted and it's not the easiest. I just put my phone on a tripod so I can show you. Hold it from here to just hold it, but you tilt from the top. You see it goes forward and you can tilt back. Just be gentle with it. It does feel a little bit stiff, but it does tilt. It's just, you would think tilting it this way would do something, but you have to tilt from the top. There is no height adjustable here. There is no speakers. You can use your headphone jack or connect speakers that way. It is kind of annoying. So when I start, sometimes when I plug in my computers,
it gives you the option of, it usually goes defaulted to the monitor. So I'm like, where is the sound? Let's talk about the resolution. The monitor is a 4K monitor. However, my computers are not both 4K. My Lenovo is 4K, which is the resolution output that you see right now. The HP is, I believe it goes up to 1080. So you're gonna see some differences when I go to picture by picture. So here's just some footage of what I shot with my drone, but while that's going, I'm gonna show you kind of the menu. So you have your return option. You use this little toggle under here. And then your power option is below return. Then you can pick the source. This is not in picture by picture mode, so you can toggle between sources if you choose to using that button. This shows the picture by picture, which I'll get to shortly. The other menu items, this is information about the system. On the picture, you can determine the brightness, the contrast, the color. You toggle to the left to go back. There's an eye saver mode on here, which helps with fatigue. However, I know that's supposed to help with fatigue, but it's like a light brown tint, and it's not something I use at all. So let's keep it off. And this would be game mode, but as you can see, I don't do games. So if you like to put that on, you can. It's definitely not really good for this type of setup, as you can just see what happened when I changed. The on-screen display. So you can move from left to right. You can set the language and the display time. So this basically shows how long the menu will stay on until it is not in use, which is set for 20 seconds. You can even do the transparency of the menu. You can test to do a self-diagnostics. This shows the version of the display port. This shows the option to be able to turn on and off FreeSync, which basically FreeSync eliminates screen tearing without the usual lag. Off timer plus is an option. Basically, it can turn off the monitor at a certain amount of time. Right now it's off. I could have sworn it was on. I do unplug this daily because I just don't want it being plugged up all the time. You can do PC or AV mode. And just the PC and AV mode. PC is best used, of course, with the PC, and then AV is similar to when you plug in like something into the AV jacks within a TV, so it helps with like gaming and watching movies. When I clicked on AV, it got really bright and large. Probably not something I would want to stay in, so I'm going to switch it back to PC. Source detection, so decide if you want it to be auto or manual. So basically when you plug it in, it automatically pulls up, you know, what is plugged into the HDMI ports or the display port. And key repeat time is configuring the response rate of a button when the button is pressed. Status of the power LED, which I have it on standby. And of course, reset all, but I'm not going to do that. Now let's go to picture and picture by picture. Right now it's off. Before we go on, I will say I really like the real estate that I have here. So I'm someone that has a lot of tabs open at a time, but I like being able to, you know, here's my blog. If I'm working on my blog, I can kind of have this. And some computers, like the LG, has it broken down into like four basically four windows, but you can basically create your, it's like a little canvas, you can create your own here. So I can have basically little windows working from different applications open, and it allows me the freedom, you know, if I'm working on something that I want to put right under each other and I'm kind of copying and pasting, I like being able to do that. So here's what happens when you go to picture by picture. So it's off. Let's turn it on. Here is my personal computer over here. So of course you don't have that much space. So depending on what you're trying to do, usually I just try to use Chrome while I'm in the picture by picture mode. Now let's turn on the second monitor. So you can see the difference. I just pulled up something on my work computer that was appropriate. So not to give away too much confidential information. So basically this is picture by picture. Here's my Lenovo is on the left, my HP is on the right. And for this instance on this right monitor, the HP, I like to extend the display so that I can work between the laptop and also the monitor, so I can kind of, you know, move back and forth and have spreadsheets open and things like that. This is the resolution of this laptop. Is not as good as over here on the right, which is 4K. So you have to be mindful of that. If you're buying a 4K monitor, be mindful of the resolution that your laptop puts out. So I like it. It gets the job done. Some people might not like the restriction and kind of the small space. So say example, I wanted to watch YouTube on the HP as well as craft an email. It's not that much to go with. Kind of have to make things small, and then, you know, are you really going to be able to see it? So that's why I extend it between the laptop. Now I will show you the picture in picture. So say I wanted to, so basically you would choose a screen size, and that's why it's basically side by side right now. You could do picture in picture. So here we have the HP at the top, kind of limited to just this top corner, and then everything on the right is the Lenovo computer.
I like the Samsung UR55 4K monitor. I don't plan on returning it. Some of the things that I really like is that it's true picture by picture and doesn't require a software to accomplish it. I also like the fact that the quality of the picture is good, and also it's easy to navigate and set up. I don't like I mentioned earlier, that you have to toggle between the speakers, so it defaults to the monitor speakers. It takes a little bit long, as you can see throughout the video, to recognize the source and the input, but I'm going to keep it. The size I thought was a little bit big but when I first got it, but I've gotten used to it.
So at the beginning, I promised you information on how I'm able to use one keyboard and one mouse for both laptops, because what good is being able to view both if I have to work with two mice or two keyboards? Well, I had an interesting challenge with this. I was not able to download like a virtual KVM or install a KVM, and also purchasing a physical KVM looked very expensive. I'd already spent quite a bit on this monitor and I really didn't want to do much more. I went to search for keyboards and mice that could connect to both computers, and what I came across is the Logitech Performance MK850. It connects to three devices and it connects via Bluetooth and wireless. So on my HP, I have it connected via a dongle. And on my Lenovo, I have it connected via Bluetooth. I've programmed 1 and 2 and for now, and if I wanted to extend it to a tablet, I could do that. When I want to switch between the two, I just hit 1 or 2 up here. So here on the left, I'm using it now. To go to the right, literally just switch and then switch, and then I'm over here. So it's not like you can go across the screens. I think there is some type of solution that allow me to be able to like copy and paste from each screen, but I would have to install software, and again, I can't install. So this works for me right now. This ran me about $80. It was on sale. I like it so far. It does get quite dirty. I literally wiped this off before I started this video, and like it's already dirty right there. But I really like this, and if you want, I can do a full review. But I'm so glad I was able to connect both. Thanks for watching this video. Be sure to subscribe. If you have this monitor, let me know your thoughts on it. Or if you plan to get it, let me know in the comments below.